Hey you guys, it's Lacey. So I'm bringing you another house building video today. This house is called Modern Bliss. It's a super modern, ultra contemporary house. I have had a lot of requests lately to make a super modern house. So basically that's what I did. I made a modern house. So I hope you guys like it. It's very different. I try some different things with it that I think turn out to be really neat in the end. Basically here what I was trying to do is figure out the layout of the interior of the house, basically for the windows sake, because I knew I wanted a lot of like big modern like floor to ceiling windows in this house, so I kind of needed to know where you know, the general layout of the house was going to be. So that's why I did that. And this right here is basically, I'm working on like the great room, which is like the living room, but it's like all combined with like the dining area and, oh, I don't know what just happened there. Oh, apparently I needed to put it on a bigger lot, so that's what happened. Okay, that was my bad that that just happened. But anyway, so yeah, I put this on a bigger lot. I kind of remembered the general look of the outside of it. So yeah, that's why I did that. It's kind of odd, but okay. So this over here is the master bedroom and master bathroom. It's all very big. It takes up like one whole half of the house pretty much. Except for, I do actually try to make like a makeshift like garage in this house. Mainly just for the purposes of the, you know, the exterior look, and I wanted to see if it could be done just to make it look like it was a garage, so we'll see if that ends up being okay, but I don't know. So, yeah, that is the, that whole half of the house, and then I make this sunken, living room, kitchen, dining area. It's all sunken. So it looks really good, I think. I think it turns out really good in the end. And that right there that I just did was what I'm going to try to make like a garage. So yeah. I mess with the roofing quite a bit in this build. To be honest, I really did not know what I wanted to do. So it took me forever to figure it out. I wanted to like try a bunch of different things, but what I end up doing in the end is I just make most of it like all like a flat roof, so hopefully it won't be too bad. And of course I make the roof, you know, go over the edges there, and also I make the backyard into like quite a large like porch area, like covered porch area, which I think ends up looking really cute in the end. So this is where I'm trying to figure out what I want the roof to be, which obviously it doesn't end up working too well. I end up changing all of this, so what you're seeing here is not, yeah, it's not gonna look like this. It's just me trying different things and figuring out what I want to do. And then I'm like, that looks like crap. So, yeah. It gets changed here shortly. Not after, like, an, like, seriously, it took me, like, forever to figure out what I wanted to do with this roof. I swear, I'm thinking it probably took me a good half hour of just messing around with things. I should have cut that part out, so I apologize for that, you guys, that you guys get to see me messing with the roof for, like, several minutes here, which turned out to be, like, a half hour of me doing it, but just a couple minutes of you guys seeing it. So, yeah, I should have cut that out, so, yeah, sorry about that. But anyways, now I'm just trying to see how that would look with like a white roof, or like a pretty much a white roof. See how that looks, but I didn't like that either. So, basically that This area right here, nah. Okay. The area that pokes out there in the front, I basically make that, I put a second story on that. It's not usable, but I put a second story over that. And, you know, I think it looks better that way. So, and then I try to put a fence around the whole thing to see what that would look like. And I'm like, no, that doesn't look modern at all. So that changes as well. And here's where I'm going to put in that second story, which I don't pull it all the way back like that. So, yeah, you'll see very shortly that I'm like, oh yeah, I can't pull it that far back. So that's what I do there. Then I put that white trim around the whole house. I think I use white trim, don't I? And then I change the roof color, I'm pretty sure. I use this stone around that area. I think that stone is very modern and very cute. I really love that stone. And then I use this wood paneling for most of the rest of the house. Yeah. I really love the way this turns out. It's very modern. It's a lot more modern than I have used recently. And this area right here is something that I thought was a really cute idea to make it look like a shuttered. You know, I use shelves and then size them up and then just, you know, place them in there to make it look like shutters. And I think it ends up looking really good. Granted, I had to go in like 2 or 3 times because every time I would save it and then go back, there'd be like 5 or 6 of the shelves missing. So I'd have to go back in and re-add them in. I think they're all there now, though. When it's finally up on the gallery, I'm pretty sure they're all there, so. It's just with sized up things right next to each other, for some reason they sometimes disappear randomly, so. Okay, so that right there is the kitchen, that's a bathroom, and then, and then I'm trying to figure out right here, which is going to be a garage, I was trying to figure out what I wanted that to look like. And I saw somewhere, I'm not sure where I saw, that somebody said that you can use these brown blinds to kind of, you know, like, it kind of looks like a garage door a little bit. So I don't know, if you guys don't like that, you can take that out and just put windows in it and make it a room or something, because right now it's unusable space. It's just like a, you know, I think originally I put in a sized up toy car, and I think I ended up taking it out, but if you guys want to put that back in, or if you want to just take that all away and make it like an office or a skill building room, then you can do that too. No biggie. Okay, so this is the back porch area. I had a few ideas of what I wanted to do. I was thinking about doing this, but then I was like, nah, it doesn't look right. I delete that and then just put the columns there, because the columns will go all the way from the ground to the roof there, even if there is a foundation. So I really like that it does that. Now I'm changing the color of the roof. I think I just choose that brown. I'm pretty sure I do. Okay, so now I'm going and finishing up all the windows in the house, which, again, they're very modern. They're very cute. I love it. Ends up looking very good. Now, out this back porch area, there is a door leading out to the back porch from the master bedroom and from the living room. So I feel like there's two leading out from the living room into the, like, onto the porch area. Yeah, I think there is. Okay. Yeah, there is. Okay. Yeah, there's two doors there. And then this is all windows right here for the most part. There are three bedrooms in this house and two bathrooms. So one main bathroom and then one, the other one is for the master bedroom. So here I'm going in and putting in just stairs, to come out of the house onto into the porch area. But it kept messing up. I don't know why it was doing that, so I had to fix it like several times, as you can see. So I just leave it as just one little step there. So yeah. And there it goes messing up again. I don't know why it was doing that. I really don't. It was stupid. All right. So, 11 minutes in, we are going to start on the gardening here. I use like this wall, like not all the way connected to the columns. I wanted them to be all separated. I just thought that it looked really cute like this, and then especially with the landscaping that I end up doing, I think it looks really good in the end. So yeah, I put these like round sort of like bushes. Oh no, not the, I didn't use the round ones. Okay, well I used the those ones apparently. And then on the ends of the gates, not the gates, that wall there, I use those and I think it looks really cute. But yeah, I think it's very like modern, contemporary, and I think it's very like fits in well with this world. I do put some grass, but not a lot. And I really love this lot right here. I use this lot like a ton. I don't know why, I just do. I think it just looks really good and super cute. All right, so there's where I do like that sort of makeshift garage area. And I do like the driveway up to it. I don't know, I haven't made any garages in this game, obviously, because there are no garages, but I really wanted to see if I could like fake it, I guess, because I know in The Sims 3, I like in every single one of my houses, I would put a garage. That was just how I love garages. So, see, and that's where it, like, five or six of them shelves deleted, like, for no reason whatsoever. So I put them back in, and I think I end up having to put them back in like one more time or something. So yeah, I just went around the house with the dirt to make it look very real, realistic. That's my sized up car, which I think I size up one more time because, yeah, I do. Make it look more life size, I guess. But I think I end up deleting it in the end. I'm not sure. I use very bright colors in the house. This is like a green color. I love that green color. I love the salmon color that I use in the master bedroom. I think it's super cute. And I use like this dark wood for the flooring in the living room and kitchen area. I think it looks really good in the end. But yeah, I think you guys will really like it. I really love the interior of this house. Like, it's so detailed and so cute. I really love it. And I really think that you guys will love it too because just for the simple fact that it is very detailed and I use a lot of like different things that I have not used in many of my previous houses. So, I don't know. Let me know what you think in the comments below if you like the way this house turned out. I really like it, and I really hope you guys like it. Anyways, so basically, this is the main, yeah, the main floor or the main bathroom for the house, and I think I'm gonna start on the out, yeah, the gardening now, finally. Very deserty, very I don't know, like tropical feeling, I guess. A lot of rocks, a lot of I use a lot of them bamboo trees. I love them bamboo trees. I think they're so cute. I love them. I use a lot of very tropical trees in this build. But I really like the landscaping in this build. I don't know why. I just really like the way it turned out in the end. So yeah, I don't know. I use a good mix of like all kinds of different things, all kinds of different flowers, but for the most part, it's like very tropical feeling. So I leave a lot of open grass. I mean, not a ton of open grass, but a lot. Just, you know, I didn't want to make it too crazy and filled in. So yeah, there's the front. I'm going to go on the side here where I do quite a bit on the side here. I usually don't put a lot of gardening on the sides of my houses. I usually just do like one or two little patches of, you know, like garden patches or something, but I actually do quite a bit on this side. I want it to kind of look like there's like a walkway or something in there, so yeah, and I put a table in there. I thought that looked really cute with like a little table and a grill out there for your grilling needs. So yeah, there's another little patch there, and back here I'm going to do a garden area for your Sims to do their gardening. I do a ton of palm trees back here. I think it looks super cute. And then I do some of, I don't know, I don't. I thought I put in like one of them aspen looking trees. Oh well, okay. So now I guess I'm going to start on the interior here. I put a fireplace right here. On the other side of that wall is the kitchen, and apparently I am not doing that yet. Was looking for some roof decorations. I believe those are the only two I end up using. Oh, and now I need to start gardening on this side of the house, which I'm pretty sure this is the only thing I do right here as far as that goes. I think I do like a walkway. Or maybe I don't. I thought I did, but I must have left that all grass. Okay, oh well. But I am going to start on the kitchen now, which I think I love this kitchen. I think it looks really good. I love this idea of having these sto two stoves like over here, like in that little nook all by themselves. I think it ends up looking really good. And being, for some reason, since this was a sunken kitchen, it would not let me place these counters right. So I had to hold Alt down to place them. I mean, it was no big deal. It was just kind of a pain having to hold Alt down. So yeah, and then basically I had some trouble fitting in those, which I did end up fitting them in. Thank God. All right, so I use like darker colors in here, and I'm sorry if it's like dark and you can't really see it very well. It will soon, you know, brighten up a bit once I get some lighting in there. I was trying to figure out what I wanted to do with the cabinets there, but no biggie. So yeah, I really love this kitchen. I know I do put blinds on these windows right here, but not like it's not all covered up. I think the bottom part of it is still open to look outside. So now I'm going in and adding some lighting and some decorations. Yeah, I really love this house. I think it looks so cute. I do this super modern table here, just 4-seater, because it's just like, you know, it's a medium-sized house. It's not huge. It doesn't need a huge dining table. I wouldn't have been able to fit it anyway. I believe I put blinds here. Yeah. So, you know, so you have that feel to where you can close the blinds if you want them, but But you still want to see outside. You still want to have that view of the outside when you're sitting around eating your dinner. So here I put like a little computer desk, and then I use like these little accents to make it look like very detailed and filled in. I will put stuff on them shelves very shortly. Here is the TV in the fireplace, which I use them lights. I'm not sure what from what I know it was a reward for having certain expansion packs or having all of them or something, I don't know, for The Sims 3. But yeah, you guys, if you guys don't have those, you can just put whatever you want there. So yeah, this is the living room. Very cute. I love this living room. It's very modern. I love those lights too, them hanging lights that I use. I absolutely love them lights. I think they are so modern. They're so cute. Yeah, I just love them. I think I have some lights that look like that are hanging in my trees in my yard, like in my front yard. They're hanging from my trees, but they're like solar lights. And they're like all different colors, like blue and green and red, and they're like all different colors, but they're about that size. I don't know. I just thought I'd tell you guys that for some strange odd reason. Okay, so this is the foyer area. All I do is put an accent table in there, a mirror, and like just a few little decorations and stuff to make it look nice and lived in and pretty. Yeah, I end up putting something there. Maybe I don't put anything there. I don't know, it just wasn't turning out like it wasn't placing things like right in the middle, and it was making me so mad. So I guess I just don't put anything there. Apparently. All right, so now I'm gonna go into the main bathroom, which I believe is black, gray, like a dark gray with white marble tile on the floor. I really love this bathroom. It's super cute. But yeah, so what did I put in that corner right there? Maybe a hamper? Yeah, hamper. Okay. I love this bathroom. It's so cute. Kind of plain, but at the same time, like, I don't know. I really love it. I think it's all done. Yep, it's all done. So now I'm gonna go in and do this hallway. Basically, I just put lighting and like a few paintings and stuff in here. Nothing to make it look like crazy. And then, yeah, I put an outdoor trash bin outside because if you don't have one of those, then you won't be able to empty your trashes on the inside of the house. So I put out an outside trash bin for you guys. And this is the main or the master bedroom. I love these colors in here. It's like a pinky salmon color. Yeah, I would call it like a salmon color. Maybe like a little bit pink with like orange undertones or something. But I really love this color, and I guess you could say that maybe this house is for like a woman, or well, it's like definitely a family house because it has two kids' rooms, but like the woman definitely is like in control, and she definitely like does all the decorating in the house. Because I would never see like a guy with these color, like this color scheme, and it definitely the woman of the house decorated this house. So yeah, I'm going into the master bathroom now, which is very cute. I use this that rectangular looking bathtub, and I was gonna put the shower in there, but for some reason, because that sized up car was right there, it would not let me place like anything up against that wall. It was making me so mad. Which I believe that's why I ended up taking the car out, because it wasn't letting me place anything there. But it's all right because I end up putting the shower on the other side there. And I'm like, well, I'm going to have to do something because I have to have sinks in here and it wasn't letting me place them. So this is what I end up doing. I end up doing these white sort of, them counters, I really like how they like go in like that at like an angle. I really like that. So yeah, I don't know. So now I am almost done with this bathroom. I believe I do add a few little like decorations and like shelves on the walls and stuff just to give it a little bit of character and stuff. So obviously there's not really much you can put on the shelves yet. They don't really have a whole lot to choose from as far as things you can place on the shelves. Like they have a f like two little pictures and like you can place tissues on there. And like one of them little stacks of books. I mean, there's only like six things that you can even place on there. So, this is the boys' room. I feel like it's like maybe a teenage boys' room. It's definitely a teenage boys' room. I really like it though. I really love the big windows in these bedrooms. Just like one whole wall is windows, basically. I really love that idea. I make it very like, I don't know. It's definitely a teenager's room, though. I like it. I do a lot of football posters in there. And just some, like, a rock star poster. And over here, I believe I put a dresser with a book bag and a mirror. And then maybe, like, a. What a. Do I put anything over in that corner? Oh, yeah. A little chair. I thought I put a chair in there. I just wasn't sure. This is the girls' room. It could be a child, girl, or a teenager. I'm not really. I think it could be either or. I definitely made it like super girly, like very girly. To be honest, it could be a teenager's, maybe a teenage girl's room, but I don't know. I think it will work either way for a child or a teenager. So, but yeah, so we're coming up pretty close to the end of the build here, and we're going to be going into the screenshots very shortly, pretty much right after I finish this room. I really hope you guys like this house. I really love the way it turned out. Very modern. I really love it. So yeah, please don't forget to like and comment on this video. And if you guys don't subscribe, you should definitely subscribe. I do like at least two house building videos per week, and then in between that time, I do let's plays and let's furnishes and stuff like that. So subscribe for daily Sims 4 videos. Yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I really, really appreciate it. And ooh, yeah, I had to do that again, didn't I? Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Bye, you guys.